So let's say if somebody has a UV light in their system, is what are the optimal operating conditions?
They need to be maintained. You know, the bulbs have to be changed periodically, very similar to the bulbs in a tanning bed needing to be changed. UV ultraviolet systems like that, the bulbs break down and they are no longer producing the UV energy that we want them to. So they might be on, but it's really not doing what we want it to do. And so, yeah, they need to be maintained. They need to be serviced. They need to be changed. When it comes to location, just depends. You know, sometimes we'll put it in the return duct, which is right above a filter or an air cleaner. So sometimes we'll put it there. Sometimes we'll put it up above the furnace, up above the coil to shine light down on that. It kind of just depends on what our goal is. Are we trying to sterilize and kill germs, bacteria, viruses in the air? Are we trying to surface clean a particular item like a coil in an air conditioning system or something like that? It just depends. It's when it comes to UVC energy killing germs, viruses, and bacteria, we call it dwell time. So it's all a matter of how long is that spore, if you will, like dwelling on that bulb. How long is it exposed to the bulb? Because the longer it's exposed to the bulb, the higher likelihood that we have a kill rate, that we're killing and neutralizing that virus. And so that's why when we put in UV systems, we help coach our homeowners on blower. How long is the blower running? How slow is the fan running? The slower the fan, the higher kill rate, because it's right. The air is moving slower. Therefore, a virus that's airborne is also moving slower across that lighting system.
Thanks. If anybody has any questions, just leave them in the comments and we'll answer them for you.
Yep.
All right. Thanks, Matt.